हेलो, दिस इज डॉक्टर एम श्यामला गौरी फ्रॉम एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर ट्रिपल ई ईरोड सिंगुंदर इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वेरियस ऑब्जेक्टिव टाइप क्वेश्चंस इन इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन्स। सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स रिवील अबाउट द मैग्नेटाइजेशन नेचर ऑफ द मशीन। द ऑप्शंस आर नो लोड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, लोड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, आर्मेचर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, बोथ नो लोड एंड आर्मेचर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स। The answer is both no load and load characteristics, because in no load characteristics it provides the residual magnetism and magnetic strength of the magnetic material. In load characteristics it can able to it will produce the torque produced capability of a machine of a magnetic material. So both no load and load characteristics will provide the magnetization nature of the machine. Next, the external characteristics is plotted between terminal voltage versus armature current at constant excitation. The field current should be constant. Next question, the armature characteristics is also known as regulation characteristics, because it is so called due to that the fact that the difference in terminal voltage helps to determine the voltage deviation. So the armature characteristics is also known as regulation characteristics. Next question, the air gap line represents magnetic behavior of the air gap of a machine. For a given DC generator, the external characteristics is plotted. Without using further plot, how can we obtain an internal characteristics? So from the external characteristics, by adding IARA, that is by adding armature resistance drop, we can able to obtain the internal characteristics. Next, the voltage drop in terminal voltage from no load to full load in shunt generator can be compensated using aiding series field. By adding series field in the shunt generator, the armature reaction drop can be compensated. Next, why is armature of a DC machine is made of silicon steel stampings? This is mainly to reduce the hysteresis loss, because the silicon steel has very high permeability and makes the flux past consistence, thereby making lesser losses. Next, what losses occurs in teeth of the DC generator? Both eddy current as well as hysteresis losses occurs in the teeth of the machine. Next question, for a 220 volt level compound generator, the terminal voltage at the half load is, it is same as no load voltage, so it is called as a level compound generator. Next question, for a DC shunt motor of 5 kilowatts running at 1000 rpm, the induced torque will be, we have a calculation, we know that power is equal to 2 pi NT by 60. From that, torque can be calculated by power by speed in revolution per second. So 5000 divided by 2 pi into here, then speed of the motor is given as 1000 rpm. So 1000 divided by 60, so that we will get 47.76 Newton. This is an induced torque for the given values. Next question, the flux and the internally generated voltage of a DC machine is non-linear function of its magnetomotive force. Next, it is advised not to run DC series motor with no load. Why? Because at no load, the torque will be zero. It will make the speed to be very infinite. The motor will get damaged permanently. Next question, for a 100 hp 250 volts compound DC motor with a compensating winding has a field current of 5 amps to produce a voltage of 250 volts at 1200 rpm, what will be the shunt field current of this machine at no load? The answer is 5 amps only, because at no load, the armature current is zero. So internally generated voltage 250 volts, so that 5 amps will be sent only through the shunt field at no load because the armature doesn't carry any current. So the answer will be 5 amps. Next question. A DC shunt motor is connected to the source through 3-point starter. Suddenly, if the starter handle is moved fastly from on off to on position, then what will happen? Normally, as a starter is placed very rapidly from off to on, the resistance seen by the machine will be very less, so that it will draw more current. So it is advised to move a starter handle slowly from off position to on position. Next question. Yes, starting resistance is inserted at the starting in an induction motor as well as DC motor. The induction motor has to control starting torque, whereas in DC motor, it is done to avoid large current. Next question. Considering a human-handed control system for the DC motor speed control, if the resistance wire is cut out too slowly, then due to the slow cutoff of the resistance, the current will be high for large amount of time. Then it will cause the machine to burn. This is an answer. The starting resistance would burn. Next question. A 100 HP, 250 volt, 350 amps DC shunt motor with an armature resistance of 0.05 ohms. To limit maximum starting current to twice the rated of its value, what will be the number of stages at starting resistance? The answer is 3 approximately. The shunt motor starters that can be used is 3-point starter and 4-point starter. Both the starters can be used for DC shunt motor. A thyristor controlled starter is preferred over DOL starter due to lesser losses. The thyristor controlled method is more efficient and it has very lesser resistance and the losses will be while operating. Next question. For a 7.46 kilowatts, 200 volts DC shunt motor with full load efficiency of 85% has armature resistance of 0.25 ohms. Calculate the value of starting resistance in ohms for a current 1.5 times of full load current. This problem, the full load current will be power value 7.46 kilowatts, that is 7,460 divided by 200, that is voltage and the efficiency. We'll get the full load current value of 43.88 amps. The starting current, it is given as it is 1.5 times of full load current. So that 1.5 into 43.88, you will get 65.883. The resistance is V by I. Here V is 200 and the I value is 65.883. By substituting these values, we'll get the resistance of 3.038 ohms. So that the starting resistance will be 3.038 minus, we have to subtract the armature resistance here. So the armature resistance 0.25. So the remaining starting resistance value will be 2.788 ohms. Next question. The effect of fringing increases as V. The fringing is an effect in which the magnetic flux lines bulge out of the fluxes and it is introduced at the air gaps. So this will get increases only when increase in air gap. The answer is as we increase the air gap. Next question. The post effect of armature reaction. Actually, there is no post effect, no such post effect of armature reaction. Armature reaction is a phenomena of affecting the working condition only. So, what are the options given? The answer is none of the mentioned. Next question. If the students give the forward shift of 10 degree to the DC generator, then इट रिड्यूसेस द फ्लक्स पर पोल. एक्चुअली ये जनरेटर गिवन ए फॉरवर्ड ब्रश शिफ्ट विल गेट इट्स फ्लक्स डेंसिटी रिड्यूस्ड एट द पोल एज द फ्लक्स विल बी इन द ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन. सो द आंसर इज रिड्यूसेस फ्लक्स पर पोल. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, ए डीसी मशीन इज रन एट रेटेड स्पीड in forward direction and then in backward direction. It is observed that speed of the rotation are different, then it leads to the conclusion of the reason behind it is because of incorrect brush placement. Next question. For a DC machine, its commutator has a diameter of 50 and rotating at a speed of 1000 rpm for a brush width 1 centimeter. The time commutation taken by the machine will be, so that explanation, the time commutation is brush width divided by peripheral velocity. The brush width it is given it as an 1 into 60 divided by pi into 50 into 1000. The answer is 0.38 milliseconds. Next question, PWM control of a DC motor varies. It varies linearly with the speed, because the duty ratio of a PWM technique is linear function with respect to speed. Next question, the Ward-Leonard system of speed control is not recommended for constant speed operation. Next question, which of the following cause and effect behavior in speed control is correct when field resistance is increased? When field resistance is increased, EMF actually decreases. So the wrong option is increase in EMF. The answer is increase in EMF. At a very low speed, increase in field resistance will decrease the speed of the motor. These two are inversely proportionate. At low speed, in armature current, it is caused by decrease in EMF. It will not be enough to compensate for decrease in flux in induced torque equation. What affects the terminal voltage of DC shunt motor? Normally, the terminal voltage is affected by compensating winding. Small DC motors have best speed control by armature voltage control. This is a voltage control method below the base speed. So for small DC motors, the best speed control method is armature voltage control. To implement armature voltage control, it must ensure that the condition is that it is used on separately excited machine. We cannot use it for an self-excited machine, because when we vary the armature voltage, the excitation may get varied. So this is used only on the separately excited machine. The armature voltage control works for speeds below base speed, and field resistance control works well for speed above base speed. The torque limit of speed of a shunt motor remains constant till base speed. Dash test is used for determining the efficiency of a traction motor. So field test is used for determining the efficiency of a traction motor. If the field current and armature current are reversed, then the direction of rotation remains same, because both are reversed. If any one is reversed, the direction of rotation of a machine will get reversed. If both field current and armature current, if both are reversed, the direction of rotation of a machine remains same. Mark the possible causes of overheating of commutator in a DC machine. The overload. Overload is a maximum possible cause. If Hopkinson test on two DC machines, machine A has field current of 1.4 amps and machine B has field current of 1.3 amps, which machine acts as a motor? Normally, The second will act as a motor because generator will have a more field current, motor will have a less field current. So second machine will act as a motor. In a Hopkinson test, the same question, which one will act as a generator? First one will act as a generator, first A machine. In Hopkinson test is also called regenerative test due to actually, the regenerative phenomena utilizes the energy of a running machine to tap the dynamically produced energy and use it to charge battery. So the option is A, the energy of one machine is used to drive other. Which is the most appropriate relation to find efficiency of a generator? The answer is output divided by output plus losses. This is an most appropriate relationship to find the efficiency of a generator. Next question. The efficiency of a Swinburne test can be found. True, because constant losses are known so that we can calculate the efficiency in the Swinburne test. Next question. The possible assumptions are made while doing Swinburne test. First one is mechanical loss constant. Second one is armature reaction neglected. Third one is increases in flux. The option is first and second. There is decrease in flux due to positive temperature coefficient of a resistance in a shunt machine. So the first and second are the answers. Next, Swinburne's test is applicable to those machines in which flux is practically constant. The quantities needed to complete retardation test are dW by dt and moment of inertia. These two quantities are required to complete the retardation test. Next question, similarity between Hopkinson and field test is that both need similar mechanically coupled motors. For Hopkinson test and for field test, the machine have to be mechanically coupled together. The rotating amplifier are widely used in large amplified outputs. The rotating amplifiers are applicable in feedback system giving large amplified outputs. Next question, the quantity which makes a rotating amplifier applicable in large power levels are? The answer is high power gain and favorable transient conditions. Next question, the ordinary DC machines are not favorable as amplitude due to sludge transient response. What is the main concern before doing Hopkinson test for finding efficiency? The main concern is it requires identical shunt machines. Next question. The retardation test on DC shunt motor is used for finding stray losses. Next, in rotating amplifier, the armature reaction MMF of the first stage is made to act as a field flux for second stage. Yes, it is true. Next, the cross field machines have two fluxes electrically in quadrature. In cross field rotating amplifiers, there is two stages of flux generator. A DC motor is connected in sharp shunt configuration, but series and shunt windings are interchanged by mistake, and the motor is connected to the rated voltage. It is neither of the winding gate short circuit. In short circuit configuration, the winding interchanging does not affect the configuration of a setup. So none of the winding gate affect. Next question, metadyne is dash feedback with respect to main dash. The answer is metadyne is a negative feedback with respect to main current flowing in the second stage set of motors. Next question. An amplidine D-axis flux is always neutralized due to compensating winding at all possible loads. Actually, the D flux is neutralized by compensating winding at all possible loads, as the same flux will be produced but in the opposite direction so as to cancel the flux. In amplitime, the resultant D-axis flux is field flux. Amplitimes are best applicable in feedback control systems with the regulated power supply. Interpoles provide MMF more than armature MMF in a DC machine. Yes, it is true. Interpoles nullify the armature cross-magnetizing flux and the reactance voltage. So it is more than the armature MMF for a good efficient machine. The delay of the commutation occurs due to base cause of EMF induced due to self-inductance and mutually inductance. The commutation in a DC machine is delayed because of EMF induced in the coil and mutual interaction of the flux field with the neighbor coils. So the answer is self-inductance and mutual inductance. In the following applications of a DC machine, but all are matched correctly, choose a wrong one. First one, DC shunt motor, variable speed application. DC compound motor, constant supply of voltage. Differentially compound motor, welding purpose. The wrong is the differentially compounded generators are only used for welding purpose, not motors. The wrong combination is third one. If the following application of a DC machines, but all are not matched correctly, choose the wrong marking. First one, DC shunt motor, lathe machines, DC compound generator, drilling machines, differentially compounded generator, welding purpose. Actually, the answer is second one. DC compound generators are used for maintaining constant voltage across the terminals. This is not used for drilling machines. Next question. Runaway for a large DC machine is avoided by using compensating windings. Why does DC motor sometimes run too fast when underloaded? This is due to weak field. With no commutating poles used, the brushes are given backward lead in the DC motor. Yes, it is true. The armature reaction flux at the trailing edge weakens the flux, and at the leading edge, it strengthens the flux in the DC motor. Next question. If a critical commutation time is 2 milliseconds, but it is observed that the practical commutation took 2.5 milliseconds, this is a case of under commutation. Since the time taken is more than the prescribed time limit for a commutation, it is under commutation. The coil undergoing commutation lies along dash, and while coil getting short circuited lies along dash for a practical DC machines. The answer is GNA and MNE. In practical DC machines, the coil undergoing commutation lies along GNA, and so as the brushes and the coils which actually get short circuited lies along MNE. This lead to sparking as a voltage difference is created at the coil. The principal contributors to magnetomotive force are field current and armature current. The interaction between the field excitation and the armature supply create the MMF, and the interconnected behaviors create EMF. So the answer is field current and armature current. The absence of compensating winding lead to statically induced EMF in the armature. The statically induced EMF inside gets reduced due to armature reaction in a large machine when there is no compensating winding is present. The number of compensating covers 75% pole span is, the answer is 3010 ampere turns. The explanation, AT per pole for compensating winding is equal to 0.7. It is 70%, it is given. So 0.7 into Z into I by 2P. Here I Z is 860 and I is given at as 1000. Divided 2 into number of poles is 10. So that the answer is 3010 ampere turns. The brushes are placed, normally the brushes are placed along the geometrical neutral axis, which is called GNA. The brushes should be shifted in forward direction in a generator for satisfactory operation of a commutation. Thank you.